Here you go. It is banana mango.
Listen, we need to talk about this.
Okay, so I printed out the same shopping list I used when I was buying Sarah's stuff. Who cares?
Who cares? We don't even know if this is a girl
yet. It is going to be, okay? Trust me, I've got a feeling. Look at this incredible stuff. Okay, wait. Is this not the most precious thing you've seen in your entire life? Wait. Oh my God. To die for.
I'm not saying that these things aren't sweet.
Hello, they are beyond adorable. And personally, I think it's good that I have something positive to focus on. I have all this energy. Why not devote it to the baby?
Because there are so many things you could be focusing on in your own life.
You know what I do every night now? I fall asleep going over in my head all the things I want to teach her. I dream about pushing her in the stroller, I swear. Oh, taking her to Mommy and Me.
Mommy and Me?
Yeah, she's gonna love it.
But honey, you're not the mommy. I am.
Okay, there's still time to turn this around here. Make one of those incredible Cooper Grand gestures.
What do you think the wedding was?
Okay, fine. Something else, then. But there's still time. It's not too late. Buzz.
That's exactly what it is. Look, we've had a window of opportunity. You know, she might have married me today, but... Yeah,
no, wait. No. Finish that. She might have married you today if what? If I hadn't pushed Jeffrey into talking to her before the wedding?
Oh, don't blame yourself. I mean, come on. It would have happened sooner or later anyway. We both know that.
Well, I better hurry up and do this because I'm about to lose my free booze privileges.
Are you ever going to stop playing the victim?
I'm sorry, do you think I enjoy feeling this way?
I think you might get some satisfaction out of it, yes. Playing the poor, pitiful me card over and over again.
Don't you dare assume to know how I feel.
You know, you kissed me today.
I was confused. My marriage has just blown up in my face.
No, not yet.
How cruel can you be?
No. You know, I feel like a bastard, okay? I feel like a bastard for all of it. That's why you're gonna still need that dress.
What?
Yeah, because I'm going to go to Buzz. I'm going to sit him down. I'm going to set him straight. I'm going to put this whole thing back on the track.
No, you're not. No.
I am not going to be responsible for ruining your life yet again,
you know,
Olivia.
Once is plenty, isn't it? Isn't it?
You think this is funny.
You can't fix it. You can't fix it. No matter how hard you try. I have been trying for 20 years to fix it. It doesn't work.
It's not too late.
Oh, it is. I've done everything. I've tried to get rid of it with men and money and booze. I've tried to ignore it and stuff it down, leave it behind. I can't. Don't you get it? What you did to me is a part, not just a part of who I am. It is who I am.
Why does this have such a strong hold over you?
All I can tell you is I can't let it go.
Do you even want to get past this anger?
What?
Well, you keep bringing it up. The hurt, the anger, the outrage.
Do you think I enjoy it?
No, I don't. But I do wonder if on some level you don't need it. Because there has to be some reason why you won't let yourself heal and move on.
I have been living with so much rage inside of me for so long, no one to direct it toward. All I have is this alcohol-tinged memory, you know, of this teenager, this... kid, really, who led me up to a bedroom and took off my clothes. And I thought for sure that I'd never see him again. And certainly if I did, he would have to be a full-grown monster.
With horns and a pitchfork.
Oh, why not? He sent me to hell. And it would be so easy to wish the worst things on him and to want to hurt him the way that he hurt me. And that's exactly what I tried to do to you when I found out that he was you.
You still have your moments.
Can you blame me? Why do you think I didn't want you anywhere near Ava? You don't deserve it. But then I saw something in you. Something that scared me.
What?
You were kind to her. You were kind. You weren't totally evil. If you had even that much good in you, it changed everything. I think I hate you more now for taking my anger away. And I have tried so hard to walk away from this. And if I had any sense at all right now, I would take off.
What was that? What were you doing?
I don't know. I don't know.
Cassie.
I'm gonna go home before I get rained on, all right? So, good luck with the bells, and I'll have some dry clothes waiting for you when you get home, okay?
Okay. Cassie. Wait, Cassie! Cassie!
These gears are jammed, man.
Did Cassie seem okay to you?
Is Cassie okay?
Yeah.
Is that what you're asking me?
Well, yeah, I guess so.
From here, the Spalding mansion looks like a birthday cake. All lit up and shiny.
Okay.
A big, happy birthday cake.
So what's your point?
She has manicured lawns. 8-car garage, and has servants waiting hand and foot on Alan Spalding. Every night he drinks the best wine, has a big Cuban cigar, and sleeps without dreams. You think he never killed Tammy, right? Doesn't matter to him. Nope, dude's living large. So to answer your question, Josh, I think Cassie's pretty damn far from being okay. Doubt she'll ever be okay again.
I don't believe that, Remy.
Believe what you want.
Look, what Cassie's dealing with right now, I can't even begin to imagine. But I know she's gonna get through it. We're all gonna get through it.
If you say so.
I'm saying it because I know it, because I believe it. Our lives are not dictated by what's happened, good or bad, in the past. I'm saying it because I know it and because I believe it. Remy, our lives are not dictated by the bad things that have happened in them. I just know that I have to have some kind of faith that there's some good, some tiny good thing that's a reason for what happened to Tammy and to Jonathan and to Sarah. It just can't all have been for nothing. It just can't.